Firstly, the huge deception that deceived the messenger of Islam. A huge deception. Okay, everyone, we must think carefully about this. The jinn was able to deceive Muhammad that he was able to convert to Islam and become a Muslim. The jinn, demons, Satan, this is our first topic. We'll examine it soon. All of the jinn, a large number of them, became Muslims. That's why every Muslim has a jinn. And Satan, the one that was Muhammad's companion, had converted to Islam. That was a lie which Muhammad himself had figured in more than one place. Let's look at those places. They're from the traditional Islamic books, and everyone must review all of the words that I'm saying. I'm warning all of you right now. I'm telling you, you should review all of what I say and see if I'm mistaken or not. See if I'm making things up or not. See if I'm speaking the truth or not. I'm telling you to doubt my words, my brother, and search for the truth yourself. See for yourself whether the facts that I present to you are true or not. I've been serving you for 20 years, and I didn't add or modify a single letter of the facts which I presented to you. It's all from your books. Let's check out those books. First, Sahih Muslim, Volume 2, page 2167. And there is Sahih Muslim right in front of you and all of its goodness. Go back to that page and check it out. What does it say? Allah's Messenger said, there is none amongst you, yes, with whom is not a companion from amongst the jinn. So every person has a jinn companion? Yes, the books say so. They said, Allah's Messenger, with you too? They mean, you too? Look at this big disaster now. He said, I have one too. So he's saying, I also have a companion from amongst the jinn. Look at this huge deception. He continues, yes, but Allah helps me against him, and he converted to Islam, and he does not command me, but for good. So here is the huge deception, that he trusted Satan, and all of what Satan says is good. That's it. Satan became a Muslim. What's there to worry about? The jinn converted to Islam, and Muhammad is being inspired by all of his good words. So then why would Muhammad doubt Satan's words? He's trapped in the snare. And this is the secret to the loss of Muhammad and all Muslims throughout the years. Yes, someone may say, okay, Abuna, that was just one book, just one reference. No, no, let's see more. This book is A Tafsir Al-Kabir by Imam Fakhruddin Razi, Volume 1, page 75. Here's the book in front of you all. What does it say? The Messenger of Allah said, yes, there is not one of you who does not have a demon. So everyone has a demon. The question is, as mentioned before, it goes on, it was said, even you, Messenger of Allah, do you also have a demon, O Messenger of Allah? And here is the deception once again. It continues. He said, I am not exempt, except Allah Almighty helped me against him, so he converted to Islam. He became a Muslim. That means he's on the good side now. He can say whatever he wants now because he's a Muslim. This is exactly the huge deception which Muhammad fell right into. Ignorant. Naive. He knows nothing about spirituality, nothing about theology. You might say, okay, Abuna, those are just two references. Well, there are many more. Believe me, there are so many that if I brought all of them out, it will last the whole episode. I'd never run out of references. But here you go. Let's look at this one also. Sahih ibn Khuzayma, volume 2, page 149. And here's the book. What does it say? The Prophet said to his wife, Maimuna, one of his wives is called Maimuna, he said, did your demon wake you up? So she woke up from her sleep and she wanted to get intimate with him. He said to her, did your demon wake you up? She said, do I have a demon? She said, do I have a demon, O Messenger of Allah? He said, yes, by him who sent me with the truth. And I also have a demon. So don't be upset. Don't be upset that you have a demon. I have one too. Except that God has helped me against him, and he became a Muslim. The huge deception. The demon convinced him, this ignoramus, that he converted to Islam and became a Muslim. So now we have three references. No, there are more than that. Let's take a look at this. Sahih Muslim again, volume 4, page 2168. And here is Sahih Muslim that we passed before. What does he say in it now? The Messenger of Allah said to Aisha, here, it's not to Maimuna, but to Aisha. He said to her, did your demon come to you? Your Satan, did he come to you? Aisha was sassy, and she responded in a sassy manner. She responded, do I have a demon, O Messenger of Allah? He told her, yes. Probably thinking, am I going to get in trouble with you? Of course. It continues. And with every person, look at her luring him into the trap. She says, and with every person, he said, yes. Okay, yes, every single person. She said, and with you, Messenger of Allah? She's like an evil genius playing chess with him. She cornered him with her words. He fell right into the trap. She goes on, and with you, O Messenger of Allah? He said, yes. But listen. But my Lord helped me with him until he converted to Islam. The huge deception. The huge deception. He believed the words of the demon. The devil is the deceiver. He deceived Adam and Eve in the garden. Do you think he's not capable of deceiving you too, Muhammad? He's so ignorant about theology, about spirituality, about all of these issues in regards to angels, demons, and everything. The critical question is this, beloved ones, what is it? Is Satan able to change and become good? Is he able to embrace religion as he deceived Muhammad into thinking? The devil was an archangel. And he had all the knowledge. And he became prideful. Pride entered into him. And then he fell, and his fall was great. And there is no salvation for him. Why? Because sin didn't come to him from an outside source. It came to him from his evil inner self. He was found guilty, and he was allowed to live far away from God. And he got separated from God. So then how would he be able to come back? In those words, are they in any Islamic books? Do any Islamic books mention that Satan is like that? Absolutely. Whoever is keen about researching will always find answers. I thank God for the gift of researching. Without deserving it, trust me. But God opens the secrets for me, for you, to be able to understand these matters. So listen and understand. Amen? This is a very important book. There's a shocking truth in it. The book is Clear Lights and Clarifying the Quran by the Quran. That's the name of the book. Clarifying the Quran by the Quran. Interpreting itself, that is.
By Imam Muhammad Ash-Shinqiti.
Volume 1, page 307. The book is before you on the screen. What does it say? So the book interprets itself. It says, whoever follows Satan, he is a kafir, a disbeliever in Allah, a servant of Satan. Did you hear that? Oh, so-called Prophet Muhammad, so-called majestic prophet. Whoever follows Satan is a disbeliever in Allah and a servant of Satan. Someone may object and come to me and say, oh no, but Muhammad's demon, his Satan converted to Islam. So what's wrong with you? Are you going to change the facts now? Muhammad already told you that his Satan converted, brother. Okay, okay. The author responded to that. What did he say? And even if his followers name him by other names, whatever names they wish, it doesn't change the facts, as they don't change just because you use different terms or words. This is something known. The truth won't change. You tell me he converted to Islam, and your Lord helped you from him and he converted? Dear Muslims, names that you call him do not matter. The truth cannot be changed. This is in your book. Your books. The problem is that you guys do not read. This is your biggest problem. You depend on having your sheikhs read the books for you. Your sheikhs deceive you in the same way Satan deceived Muhammad. You might tell me, okay, that's just one book, it's not good enough. Okay, fine, I understand. I understand that the word of two or three witnesses is proof. So allow me to give you another witness. The book, The Fruit of the Torment in Response to Those Who Do Not Judge According to the Sunnah and the Book. By Ibn Uthman Al-Ma'amr At-Tamimi. Volume 1, page 339. See the book? The tasty fruits. Do you want one of these fruits today? And become nutritious?
He's saying the exact same words as Ash-Shinqiti.
What does he say? Whoever follows Satan's legislation is a disbeliever in Allah. And Satan gave legislation to Muhammad. A disbeliever in Allah, a slave of Satan. Everyone, Muhammad, is a worshipper, a slave of Satan, because he follows his words, and he laughed at him and deceived him. Do you understand now? Do you get it now? My voice has been hurting for 20 years telling you all of this. Here you go with all of the proof and all of the evidence. Again, what did he say? And even if his followers name him by other names, So call him whatever you want. It won't work. Why? It goes on and it says, because it doesn't change the facts, as they don't change just because you use different terms. This is something known. So call Satan a Muslim. It won't change his nature. Say that Allah was gracious to him and converted him into Islam and he became a Muslim. It won't change the truth. It won't change his nature. Satan is Satan no matter what the reasons are. No matter what you say, Muhammad. Muhammad, you deceived one. Muslims, Muhammad deceived you all. Satan deceived Muhammad and he deceived all of you by accepting his words. And you swallowed the bait. So therefore you should examine yourselves and make sure that you stand right before God.